I literally can't even load into Crunchyroll. What is going on? Literally, it's breaking. Oh, no. Oh, something went... No! No! All right, Crunchyroll is not working for me. Funimation is not working for me. Hulu does not have it. Everything is just logging me out. Hey, we were able to get Funimation to work. Okay, so we're using Funimation. Let's go. What's up, Dapper Squad? It's your boy Darius back at it again with Attack on Titan Season 4, the final season, Part 2. You guys don't understand how crazy it feels just saying that. We ended in one of the craziest cliffhangers. Attack on Titan has had some crazy cliffhangers. You guys definitely all know. But one of the craziest ones, the mission for Marley to come back and attack the island, which was supposed to take 6 months, especially with how Eren delayed them during the declaration of war. They came back in a month. You have Pieck, you got Porco, you got Reiner, you got Colt, you got Magath, you got everyone, and you have Eren, who almost just got eaten by Porco and is now transforming, ready for this round fucking seven at this point. How many times they fought, I don't know. I'm so excited. I'm literally brimming with joy. I'm glowing right now. I feel like an angel. You know what I'm saying? Don't forget, if you guys want to check out the full length of this show or Demon Slayer, because that came out earlier, or the early access or full length of any of the other shows I'm doing, check out that Patreon. Links are down below. If you guys want to support me and Patreon's not really your thing, if you guys could just leave a like and a nice comment, it really does help me with that YouTube algorithm. Don't forget to subscribe. Click that bell so you guys always know when I post over here on the Dapper channel. Follow all the social medias, Instagram, Twitch, TikTok, Twitter, all at DapperDarius. Much appreciated, you guys. I say we just gotta jump right on into this. Attack on Titan, Season 4, the final season, Part 2, Episode 1. I wonder what the episode is in totality. Episode 17? Yes, Episode 17 of Season 4. Here we go. Let's do this. I'll see you guys there. Are you serious? It's starting with this? Those were not Levi's fingers. Is she just saying that to deceive them, or is he actually dead? I swear to God, this is the Titan that Zeke was put into her belly, right? How? What? Look at Levi. He actually looks dead. How? What? How didn't Levi not? I wanted him to win this faded battle so bad. Zeke is still up. Those fucking white ass cheeks, man. Come on. They're loving that. They get to see Zeke and his dong. He's still alive. Please. That's why they jumped in the water. That's the same like Aurora Borealis connecting all the paths of Eldians to the coordinate, right? That's like what Ymir saw. But what was the little girl? They have Zeke and that. Oh my god. Put some goddamn pants on. Oh, this was not the start I wanted. Oh, I'm tearing up already. Judgment, here we go. Not holding anything back, right back into it. Go get revenge for Liberio. Oh my god. Oh, we got artillery being flown in. Cannon fire and everything. They are ready for... They want all the smoke. Oh. Hey, I thought he was gonna cut the chain, but that worked too. And now we got the Cart Titan and Jaw Titan going back. Well, we got fucking reinforced, Eren. Not just normal reinforced, we got Warhammer powers now. Ah, smart. We know that's one of the safest spots you can be. She's playing the long term. She's playing the long game, especially not knowing the current updates, what's going on with Zeke. I understand why she would say this, 100%. But typical Eren. Who gives a fuck what you say? I'm Eren. I'm gonna do whatever the fuck I want. He does look badass, not only with the fucking brass knuckles, but like with the brass forearms and shit too. Not a Titan fight if they don't wreck the fucking city. See, that's the bad thing about how much time we spent with Marley at the beginning of season 4, is I genuinely like these characters. Like, Porco, he's a cool dude. Pieck, I actually like. Reiner is one of my favorites. Gabi, I'm sure, you know, but look at Magath. Look at the compassion that he's having for an Eldian, you know? Oh, I wonder what's gonna happen with Falco and fucking Zeke's spinal fluid, bro. That's still unresolved. We have like 17 storylines unresolved right now. Yes. Yes, I know. Yeah, and they never knew that. That's a valuable piece of information. Yes. Yep, they're just now finding about his heritage. Yep, man, they're able to piece together this puzzle and put together what's going on and come up with a counterplay so fast. I love smart characters. 2,000 years of malice. That artillery fucking peak looks so sweet. Who would have thought that the armored Titan would be out-armored by Eren? I would have never thought that. Ooh, okay. Oh. That was a clean left. That was about as clean. Oh, that was a good dodge. Oh, and let me just say real quick, Mappa, you guys are fucking killing the animation. Guys, looking very crisp. We got Porco. Oh, the Warhammer. He's been able to utilize that so well. He is at a disadvantage in numbers. It is hard. But his abilities make up for it. His fighting skill. Look at that. I love that shot. Jesus, Jesus. They have PTSD. I was about to say they have PTSD from Thunder Spears and shit, but okay, Pieck. Way to set the tone. Yeah, I'm glad they put Magath on the front line too, and he is the one firing this hoe. I didn't know he was their best gunner back in the day. Shouts out Magath. All that warfare right here, man. That's a lot of Eldian death. And with the airships as well. Yelena and Onyankopon are shook. I would be too seeing this. Theoretically, yeah, if they don't let him regenerate, they can just keep doing that over and over again. And Laura Tiber, don't forget about her. I really didn't think Reiner was going to come in here with a chance. I thought Eren was going to mop the floor with them, but they came in tough and ready to go. Shouts out to Marley. I got to be honest, man. Is Onyankopon gonna let them out? Yep. We need Armin. We need Armin. We need Mikasa. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, after they imprison them? Yeah, after all the. I could totally get why they feel betrayed, though. Like, my man Connie's had it. Yep, I'm done. I would be the same way. I can't blame him at all. It was just Yelena and a few others. I understand that. I believe him.
That is facts. Kids are the future. Also, that's why it's a very sticky situation. Yes, tell us the plan. Yeah, I wonder what Mikasa's gonna think. And I don't even know if that thing is true, where she has that built-in Ackerman loyalty to help Eren after what happened. Wow, she wants to. See, but now she's saying, see, I don't really know at this point. Is that true? Was Eren lying? I would have to agree. At this point, I don't know what Eren wants. I have not a single clue. Yes, ultimately what you're saying could be true. He could be playing the long, long, long game. But is he? I really had no idea. Yeah, I like how they're all sweating. This is a super nerve-wracking decision. This is literally, they're holding the fate of literally their people and their decision right now. So dead. Oh my god. This is as gruesome as it gets. Wait, that was 20. That felt like literally 4 minutes. You know, a season gets you hooked, or at least I should say, an episode gets you hooked right away when you have a notebook ready to write notes and you didn't write down a single thing. I didn't write down a single thing. It started off so heartbreaking for me. Like, this, I've never been more upset at the beginning of an Attack on Titan episode, I don't think. I'm trying to think of one, I don't think so. Starts off with just seeing my favorite Attack on Titan character of all time, by far, Levi, in the worst state I have ever seen him, ever. And it's horrible to see him that way. I'm very glad that he's still alive. I'm most certain of it because Hange did not let Flock check the pulse and she made an effort to get his body out of there in the river. Which, smart thinking of Hange to use Zeke as a distraction right there, a natural distraction built in. What power is that? Like, Zeke having royal blood gives him just Titan powers that are just crazy. Like, he can just, and I don't even know if he was able to really command that, or the Titan, the pure Titan, just instinctively put him in her belly and then he just sucked in all the steam and he literally regenerated. He was on the brink of death. That is so crazy. You saw his white ass butt cheeks too. And I'm so curious what that plain or that like desert he was in, because we've seen Ymir with this. I don't know if she was also in that desert per se, but we saw her naked and we saw her looking up at a very blue tinted area with the Aurora Borealis connected all the Eldian paths all to that point, you know, and stuff like that. Isn't that how she found the walls in the first place, if I remember correctly? But there was a weird addition of this little girl who was the one rebuilding him. Now, in terms of, like I said, maybe was it him that made the pure Titan do that, or did the Titan do that instinctively? Was it this girl? Is that girl the original Ymir? Like, that made the deal with the devil? I have no idea. Like, I wouldn't be surprised if Attack on Titan is one of those shows where, like, it's very realistic where shit just might not get answered. Like, it might not let us know that, but that's because, you know, like, they don't, the characters in the show don't know that. Like, even though Zeke has more information than damn near everyone in the show, there's still stuff that he doesn't know. So where would we get this information from? Unless there's some sort of ancient book or glossary that we're able to find from, I really wouldn't be surprised if a situation like that happened. Opening was fire. I'm going to have my own little discussion about that and talk about the opening, because I'm going to upload that separately. Super dope. And then it went right back immediately into where we left off at the end of the last season, or the end of part one, I should say. Reiner, Porco, Pieck, everyone, Colt, Magath. I'm really glad Magath is there. I really like what he said, like, Marley's, how far Marley has fallen that their best gunner has gotten such a high rank. Like, he was, I didn't know he was nice like that back in the day. But the new artillery they came up with for Pieck, like, I was like, Pieck is such a utility Titan to have around any fight, that she can help defense, offense, utility, move stuff, you know? That I was excited for her to be here. But as soon as I saw artillery that they were getting ready to put on her back, I was 10 times more hype. Because I know artillery peak is a whole different level of dangerous. Like, what she did to Eren out of nowhere, insane. Like, Eren is very intimidating 1v1 because of the limits. Not the limits, because of the variety of his abilities. But in terms of pure numbers and pure damage, like, they can do some damage. And they did. And I like how also conflicted Gabi feels about how, like, excited and not excited, but happy she was that Magath was there to, you know, rescue her, and that Marley came, Reiner came, and that Magath cares for her and stuff like that, which you can tell he definitely does. And that's what one of the reasons I love the show is that characters that you're supposed to hate, you love, and characters that you're supposed to love, you hate. It's very good at doing that, which is the duality of humanity. Like, that's how real life is. Like, the villain is a hero in someone's story, and the hero is a villain in someone's story, and that's literally Attack on Titan to a T, and I love it. And Onyankopon, that was a great story down there to convince everyone that with how things have gone, I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt. I'm like Armin, I'm believing him, but also I feel like Connie has a complete and utter 100% right to not believe him when he was like, I've been betrayed over and over and over again for years. I cannot blame him whatsoever. But he did have a good story, and I would be like Armin and believe him. So if it costs us our life being gullible, hey man, I'm on your guys' team. I feel you. Is Armin gonna go fight though? That's the real question. How are we gonna stop Eren in this plan? Is Eren the double, triple, quadruple agent that Armin was suggesting? Like, these questions are all in the air. And then we still have Levi as a plot. We still have Falco. We still have Historia. We still have a lot of different plot twists, storylines, as I was trying to say, that haven't been resolved, that we're waiting on, and I am very excited. So I love the shit out of this episode. If you guys did as well, let me know your thoughts down below. Don't forget to subscribe. Check out that Patreon if you guys want to watch the full length. Leave a comment. Oh my, leave a like, all that jazz. I'm hyped. Follow the social medias. Twitter, if you guys want to see my, like, live updates on what I'm doing, what I'm this, that, and the other, follow my Instagram, Twitch, Twitter, all the social medias, TikTok. Other than that, Dapper Squad, much appreciated. Have a great day. I will see you guys later. Make sure to drink some water. Tell someone you love them. Be safe. Don't go fighting. Don't go starting wars. Declarations. Don't turn into Titans, guys. Have a great day. Peace out.